بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. نستعين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Today is the fourth day of Ramadan. كل عام وأنتم بخير. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى accept all your good deeds إن شاء الله. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Today إن شاء الله I'll try to go through جزء 5 and 6. Tomorrow إن شاء الله will be with our sister Yamina. So probably tomorrow is not going. We are not going to do any of the ajza. So I'll try to hit the highlights of both juz 5 and 6 today. Inshallah, we'll start by finishing Surah An-Nisa, which we started yesterday. And Surah An-Nisa is the third surah that is Madani. So there is Fatihat al-Kitab, that is Makkian, and then there is Al-Baqarah, Ali Imran, and then An-Nisa, third surah. And Surah An-Nisa, as we said before, it deals with so many different things. And we said that it deals specifically with people who have problems, less fortunate, like orphans and so on. And it gives us solutions to problems. And today I'm going to try to hit the solution part. So the first thing was from the beginning of the surah, in fact, even the last ayah of the surah, it speaks about inheritance. One of the major problems that can happen among people is fighting about inheritance. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes that fully and making sure that orphans also can take their due right. But each and every person should get his due right. And this is to form, to make sure that the Islamic community is formed. The second thing is justice, which deals with in this surah and Surah Al-Ma'idah. أَدُّ الْأَمَانَاتِ أَدَاءِ الْأَمَانَةِ Giving the right things. وَإِذَا حَكَمْتُمْ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ أَنْ تَحْكُمُوا بِالْعَدْلِ That when you are judging something, you do that in the right way. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُكُمْ أَنْ تُؤَدُّوا الْأَمَانَاتِ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهَا وَإِذَا حَكَمْتُمْ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ أَنْ تَحْكُمُوا بِالْعَدْلِ Allah commands that you should render back the trust to those who have entrusted you. And that when you judge between people, you judge with justice. So number one is putting all the ground rules like inheritance. Second is when you take something, you return it to somebody if you're entrusted. Third thing is that you are ruled always by justice. Most important thing is listening to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and listening to the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ya alladhina amanu ati'u Allah wa ati'u Rasul. O you who believe, obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and obey the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is a call, O you who believe. So this is you who chose by your free will to be believers. This is the way it is. You have to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and obey the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In fact, in another surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swear, he makes an oath, and he makes an oath by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself. فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ يَرَبِّكَ يَا مُحَمَّدِ By your Lord, O Muhammad. لا يؤمنون حتى يحكموك فيما شجر بينهم ثم لا يجد في أنفسهم حرجا مما قضيت ويسلموا تسليما By your Lord Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم They can have no faith until they make you judge in all disputes between them and find in themselves no resistance against any decision that you may have and accept that with full submission. Something else in Surah An-Nisa also in order to protect communities. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it severe punishment if somebody kills somebody. And this is حُرْمَةِ الدَّمِ making sure that the blood is very valuable. In fact, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says the meaning of which الدُّنْيَا أَهْوَنُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ مِنْ إِرَاقَ الدَّمِ مُسْلِمِ The whole world is much smaller than just spilling the blood of one human being who's a Muslim, or anybody really, for that. You don't spill blood of anybody. And in Surah An-Nisa, it says, وَمَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ أَن يَقْتُلَ مُؤْمِنًا إِلَّا خَطَأ It's not becoming of a believer to kill another believer except by mistake. But when he speaks of those who do it deliberately, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يَقْتِلْ مُؤْمِنًا مُتَعَمِّدًا Whoever intentionally kills a believer, فجزاؤه جهنم خالدا فيها، وغضب الله عليه ولعنه وأعد له عذابا عظيما. And whoever kills a believer intentionally is going to have hell for eternity, wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, curse from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and a great punishment is prepared for him. So as if that's not enough to be in hell for eternity and to have the wrath and curse from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is more than that. So this is all to protect the communities. Another thing, تدبر القرآن, really reflecting upon Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ. Shouldn't they really consider, reflect, read carefully the Quran? وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجَدُ فِيهِ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا. If it was from another source than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they would surely have found contradictions in abundance. تدبر القرآن is mentioned in four surahs of the Quran. It's mentioned here in Surah Nisa, it's mentioned in Surah Al-Mu'minun, it's mentioned in Surah Sad, and it's mentioned in Surah Muhammad. So this is one way also to protect Muslims, to protect communities, to protect everybody, to protect mankind, is really to become a believer, to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, obey the Messenger, and always reflect on the Quran. Another thing that's also mentioned here in Surah Al-Nisa, Al-Islah, that you have to make things better. It's not when you go to a place, it's either you leave it either the same, or you improve on it, or you destroy it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not want us just to come there and leave it even as it is. No, you make it better, you improve on it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لا خير في كثير من نجواهم. Anything that they whisper about, anything that they speak in secret, it's not good unless من أمر بصدقة أو معروف أو إصلاح بين الناس. Except those who tell you, order you to do sadaqah, charity, أو معروف, some good thing, أو إصلاح بين الناس, أو conciliation between people, getting peace among people. So Surah An-Nisa is putting solutions for mankind for the problem one after the other. And I would conclude Surah An-Nisa to have time for Surah Al-Ma'idah by a couple of things that is mentioned here. And one of them is the ayah, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنَ دِينًا مِمَّنْ أَسْلَمَ وَجْهَهُ لِلَّهِ وَهُوَ مُحْسِنٌ. The way to proceed is, who is better in religion than those who submit themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And the last ayah, and it's very, very amazing to hear that. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَنْ يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not forgive shirk, but would forgive anything that is not shirk. And the amazing, interesting thing, it's mentioned twice in Surah An-Nisa. It's mentioned in verse 49, it's mentioned in verse 116. So twice in the same surah this is mentioned. I'm going to move quickly to Ali Imran, to Surah Al-Ma'idah. Surah Al-Ma'idah is, and you can see that from the beginning ayah. Just listen to the first ayah of Surah Al-Ma'idah. يَا الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا أَوْفُوا بِالْعُقُودِ. This is how the surah starts, and this is how it is. O you who believe, fulfill your pledges, fulfill your obligations. And the biggest pledge that we have is أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا رسول الله, with all the meaning that this word means. And this is an order, you who chose, you, يا الذين آمنوا, you chose by your own free will to be believers, then fulfill your pledges. And you fulfill that, in fact, with justice and fairness. Even if you hate some people, you still have to be fair to them. The second ayah immediately, وَتَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى وَلَا تَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ. And it starts, وَلَا يَجْرِمَنَّكُمْ شَنَآنُ قَوْمٍ أَنْ صَدُّقُوا عَلَى الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ أَنْ تَعْتَدُوا. Don't let that you hate somebody, that you hate some people, even if they prevented you from going to Masjid al-Haram, to be transgressors. And join hands in the right things. Join hands in taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't ever join together in something that is bad. إِثْمِ وَعْدْعُدْوَانِ. Don't join in a sin or transgression. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. So there is an order for pledge. There is an order immediately. Even if you might hate some people, even if they did you wrong, don't transgress. In Surah Al-Ma'idah, there is so many rulings. This is a Madani surah. And when we go, inshallah, next لسورة الأنعام, you'll see the difference between a Makki surah and a Madani surah. There is ruling about hunting, ruling about slaughtering, ruling about tahara, cleansing. There is ruling about ridda, if somebody was a Muslim, then became a non-Muslim. There is a ruling about marrying men to, when men marry in a lady from people of scripture, from holy scriptures before us. Ruling about stealing, ruling about drinking alcohol, ruling about gambling, ruling about when somebody gives, starts swearing by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he cannot fulfill the oath. Ruling about inheritance on at the time of death, when somebody gives a will to somebody, how it should be done. Then there is a long period about the discussion between Muslims and people of scripture, looking at their pledges. We said this is about pledge. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about the Jews and the Christians about that. And when he spoke about the Israelites, وَلَقَدْ أَخَذَ اللَّهُ مِيثَاقَ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ وَبَعَثْنَا مَعَهُمْ 12 نَقِيبًا وَقَالَ اللَّهُ إِنِّي مَعْكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took the pledges of the Israelites and he sent with them delegate of 12 people. And this is the ruling of the pledge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنِّي مَعْكُمْ, I am going to be with you. لَيْنْ أَقَمْتُمُ الصَّلَاةِ وَآتَيْتُمُ الزَّكَاةِ وَآمَنْتُمْ بِرُسُلِي وَعَزَّرْتُمُوهُمْ وَأَقْرَضْتُمُ اللَّهَ قَرْضًا حَسَنًا. So that's the pledge from the side of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَيْنْ أَقَمْتُمُ الصَّلَاةِ, if you do the prayers and you pay the zakah, give the zakah, believe in my messenger, honor and assist my messengers, and lend to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in charity, good loan. This is the part from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I will give you what? I will remit your sins, admit you to gardens on which river flows in paradise. But if any of you after this disbelieved, he has indeed gone astray. So the pledge is two part. One, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, if you do this, this, this and that, I'm going to forgive all your sins. I'm going to get you into paradise. But then following ayah, it says, فَبِمَا نَقْضِهِمْ مِيثَاقَهُمْ. They did not fulfill their pledge because of their breach of their covenant. That did not happen. The promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is not promising them. Because they, from their point, they did not fulfill the covenant part. And if you go to the Christians as well, وَمِنَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّا نَصَارَى أَخَذْنَا مِيثَاقَهُمْ. And from those who call themselves Christians, we took their covenant. فَنَسُوا حَظًّا مِمَّا ذُكُّرُوا بِهِ فَأَغْرَيْنَا بَيْنَهُمُ الْعَدَاوَةَ وَالْبَغْضَاءَ إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. But they have abandoned a good part of the message. They kept some, they abandoned some. So we planted amongst them enmity and hatred. And just to make sure, the pledge also goes to us. We have a pledge to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. If Muslims do not fulfill their pledge, there is no promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Kuntum khayra ummatin ukhrijat linnas. You are the best people, but there is a certain condition. You don't fulfill your pledge, it's going to be the same thing. Don't think that you are granted paradise or granted anything. I'll conclude with just mentioning in Surah Al-Ma'idah, there are three stories. Just to remind you, one is the story of Musa alayhi salam, and when he told his followers, just enter Al-Ard Al-Muqaddasa, go there, to enter the holy land, and they rejected that. Inna fiha qauman jabbarin. There are strong people. We cannot do that. Idhab anta wa rabbuka faqatila innaha huna qa'idun. You go and with your Lord and you fight. That's the first story, and this is to tell us, if you don't listen to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you are breaching the pledge. The second thing, the story of killing Ibn Adam bilhaq, the story of the son of Adam when one son killed the other because of jealousy, and that was the first murder for mankind. And the last story is the story of Al-Ma'idah, which the story, the name comes of the surah, is when the followers of Isa alayhi salam, Jesus peace be upon him, asked to send us a table from the sky that has food on it, and Allah subhanahu Isa alayhi salam made the supplication to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I'm going to grant you this, but if you don't listen, if you don't fulfill the pledges after that, then you are going to be tortured severely. I'm going to end with something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إن سورة المائدة: اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. Today I have perfected your religion and I have bestowed my bounty on you and I am satisfied with Islam as your religion. Stick to the religion of Islam. Stick to the pledges that we pledged to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Ramadan. Make always dua. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of us. Allahumma innaka afuun kareem tuhibbul afwa fa'fu 'anna. اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا. وكل عام أنتم بخير إن شاء الله رب. See you on Sunday. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.